So, you've either been living in a hole, or you just had cable and forgot all about the digital transition, and you cancel cable, and now you want to use your antenna. Well, what do you know? You can't get anything. Transition was a few years ago. What do you do now? I'm going to demonstrate how to hook up a digital converter box. What you'll need is coaxial cable, an antenna, and of course, the digital converter. To get started, of course, go ahead and position your digital converter box. For me, I like to put mine on the top of the TV. Second, if you're going to use an antenna like mine that can actually snap into your TV, go ahead and do that now. And if you want, you can go ahead and open up the telescoping part. But now from behind the TV, what do? You have the converter box just sitting there with nothing plugged in. The antenna is just dangling. And the plug's on your TV. How do you plug it into this? Well, there are two ways for plugging it into this TV, and I'll describe it for you in just a few seconds. If you're like me, and you're using this kind of antenna, and you have this kind of plug, you can't just plug it into the converter box. It doesn't work. You need a special Balun adapter, which looks like this. And what you do is you just take these little pitchforks, screw them into here, bam, plug it into the converter. Pretty easy. Let me demonstrate. Just do that. Then that one. And that's it. That's all you gotta do. And then you just plug it into the converter box. Look for the one that says in from antenna. Plug it in there, and you're all set. But, once again, what about the TV? Well, the first thing you want to do is take your coax cable and go ahead and plug it into the converter box. Go ahead and plug it in right there. You might have to unplug the transformer if you have a hard time screwing that plug in, like I'm having. So we'll just go ahead and do that. There we go. And then we'll just plug the antenna back into it again. And now we'll discuss on the options of how to plug it into your old TV set. Now, most TVs from the 80s and forward have this here. This is called an F-type connector. It is 75 ohms. Now, a lot of older TVs only have these screw terminals. These are for twin leads, and they're 300 ohms. All converter boxes output 75 ohms. Now, in the case of my TV, all I have to simply do is this. Just plug it in, screw it on, and you're all set. And then from there, you just plug in the power cord to the converter box, and you're all set to watch some TV. But if you do not have the F-type connector and a 70 or 75 ohms input on your TV, you'll need a matching transformer. Looks like this. And what you do with these, you would actually plug in the coax cable, 75 ohms, into one end, and then using your screwdriver, loosen up the VHF terminals on your TV, like that. And then slide that right in there. Need to loosen it up just a little bit more. There we go. Then you're good to go. That's all you have to do. Now, in the case of my TV, if you have both options, you'll have a switch for 75 ohms or 300 ohms. You can select between which input are you actually using. Since this is already wired up this way, we'll just use that for now. And before we try to use the TV, we have to now grab that power cord and plug it into the power strip. And now, we should be able to be greeted. First up, sound. Oh, who remembers that sound? But now, when we turn on the converter, we should be able to get a picture. Beautiful. And now if you want, you can now sit down and enjoy a nice football game. If you're hooking up your converter box today and now, on your antique television set. Try to take advantage of his lateral quickness. Reverses.